Hello boys and girls, welcome back. This is session number 2. First session my fastest lap was 1 minute 15.5 seconds. This time I'm gonna get it down to 1 minute 14.5 seconds. So 1 second better. This is the poor man's 1-point harness. First you move the seat back, then you pull on the seat belt quickly so it locks up, and then pull the seat forward so the seat belt remains locked at all times, keeps you in place. You don't want to slide around your seat during cornering. This time I got 2 cameras already rolling. You're gonna be able to see me in the top left corner. We're actually pulling out straight to the track. Session 1, I thought we're gonna be lining up at the grid. You're gonna see that in a second. This time I'm gonna cut out all the scenes, most of them, where I'm driving on my own when I have no one in front of me. It's always a bit more exciting when I'm chasing somebody. Okay, as I make that left turn here, this is the actual grid. That's what I was talking about in session 1. First lap is gonna be a warm-up lap. Okay, now we're just gonna skip to the next car I'm chasing. go, coming up through the car issue I mentioned in the last video. And right about now I feel a slight loss of power. I take my foot off the gas, turn on the hazards, I let the Mazda through, kind of listening for noises, looking at my boost gauge. I am thinking it might be the turbo, but at this point I have no idea. A lot of different thoughts going through my head. So everything seems fine. I don't hear any noise from the engine. So I get back to racing. Let's skip to where I overtake the Mazda again, and I get into a short but a scary drift on that left turn right after I take over the Mazda. Guys, it's nice and warm. Car is doing okay. I had a little loss of power. You might have noticed I slowed down for half a lap. It lasted for a second, maybe not even, and did a kind of a slowish half a lap, and then stepped on it again. The car was smoking when we were lining up for the second session. It was quite a bit of smoke coming out, but I mean, this car doesn't see nothing but you know, autocrosses and track days, so no surprise there. Although I don't drive it much, but when I drive it, you know, I drive it. So yeah, so we'll see what happens in the next session and the last one. Alright, third and last session. The car wasn't smoking as much as it did right before the second session. Right after the first session, I turned the engine off as soon as I pulled into the parking lot. After the second session, I let it idle for a few minutes, so there was less oil inside the turbo. I thought maybe the cool down lap was enough, but it wasn't. But it was smoking quite a bit when lining up for the second session, almost nothing when lining up for the third session. So didn't really baby the car. As always, aggressive, trying to be as fast as I can. So gonna cut to the more interesting bits where there is more cars around. Oh yeah, and that problem turns out to be a big one. I'm surprised the car lasted this whole session in a drive home. I'll give you a hint. The part that broke starts with a P and ends with an N. Subaru owners probably already know what's going on, what the problem is. Oh yeah, and we're gonna hear those brakes squeak a bit more often. this lap and the last one, I didn't redline it anymore in fifth gear. The loss of power thing started happening more often. Later on I even began to throw it into sixth gear just to keep going. It seemed like it was only happening at high RPMs, higher gears. Thank you. that's the end of the third session. Checkered flag right there. I'm gonna do the very last cool down lap. You might have noticed the loss of power was happening more and more often. I was switching gears at about 6,000 RPMs instead of red lighted at 7,000. So yeah, actually I'm glad this is over. Turns out to be a major issue. So the next video is going to be a repair video. And it's a major one. Along with the repair, I am modding the car a little bit more. But I will explain all that in the next Subaru repair video. Not sure when that's gonna happen. I've been having some computer issues. It's freezing on me randomly. Gotta figure that out. So thanks for watching. If you like what you see, consider subscribing, like the video, comment. Hopefully I will make it to another track day this year. And maybe at least one autocross. And I'll see you soon.